All right, we're back at it again. Well, tops a few white ones. Four white ones, four silver ones, four red ones. Red and chartreuse, silver, white, white and silver. I'd already kind of got a little bit of a head start. I already put my Sally Hansen's Hard as Nails based on my jig head. Then we're going to wrap some thread. Today what we're going to do, we're going to use what I normally use as flash, but we're going to use it for the entire tail. This is some I've got. It's kind of a holographic, I don't know, it kind of depends on where you got it, what color you're actually seeing. I mean, there's reds, greens, but basically if you're holding back out of the light some, it's basically a white. The colors in it are pretty cool. I was using one of these Saturday with just that as the tail, and I was pretty impressed when you got it under the water with a little bit of sunlight coming down on it, actually how good it glittered and shined under the water. So we're going to use that as the entire tail for this jig. And we're going to do a white head. This is the tail. And then we're going to use a white body on it. So we're going to start by wrapping that in just like we would if you was using like a rubber tail, rubber skirts, bucktail. We're going to kind of spread it around a little bit. We're going to let the thread, or we're going to see if the thread will push it. It doesn't really look like it wants to. It looks like it's going to hold it all right there pretty tight in one spot. So when you end up with that, you got all your tail material built up here and you got nothing on this side. So you got two options. You can put a little extra right in here to fill the body up. But if you're afraid you're getting your tail too thick, you can start kind of separating that and pulling it up around that hook, running it back to side. But I think with these, we're just gonna go ahead and add, and we're gonna add about that much more on the other side of it. We're gonna make kind of a thick tail on this one. I'm gonna do two of them like this tonight. The other ones I've done were just regular rubber skirts. White rubber skirts, white tail. And when you start, you're gonna kind of lay that up there at like a 45 degree angle with the head. Not, it's too hard to get your fingers down in there. So if you start it like right there at a 45, make your first wrap kind of loose. Well, it came completely out. I haven't tied a whole lot with this material. I actually usually use it as, like I said, just a flash, and I kind of experimented with it some. All right, we're gonna turn it over and see if it looks like it's covering it all right. I think it does. I think it's got it all pretty good there. So now, we'll get it all the rest of the way around the shank of that hook. Yeah, we got it wrapped up pretty good. But I tell you what, with all that white, I don't know if I can get it out of there. And this is like, it was a pack of bulk flash I got off of Amazon. It's thick, it's heavy, it don't flex a whole lot when it's short. I mean, you see it's kind of makes for a pretty stiff tail. But since we got so much white in that and it picks up other colors really well, I think we're gonna throw in a couple pieces of red with it. See how that comes out. I'm just gonna wrap that in right there at the bottom. My life is just a cold routine. Everything is That's kind of what we got going. We'll get out of the vice here in a little bit and we'll check it. I might decide I don't like it. But I think we're going to be safe because that's so stiff, and I think we're going to glue that down just one more time before we start putting our Chanel on. I think we're gonna go one more layer. We're gonna go ahead and wrap it. See how that comes out. I think it's gonna come out pretty nice. Whip finish. Pull down kind of tight and cut that off. Just put a little more glue right there in the neck. What we got. You see how it's really blue right there, and I think it's picking that color up from my vise. Let's see, let's position a little bit different. There's a lot of colors in that. And it shows up that good underwater too. So, other than that tail being split right there, because I ain't got it evened out, sometimes you gotta kind of get it lined out there with the hook. But that's what we got. I'd call it a winner. I like it. The ones I was using Saturday wasn't white. They were more silver head with the silver body. But I was pretty amazed with all the, how bright it was underwater, how good it flashed. The guy I was sending these to wasn't real picky. He's like, yeah, I like white. I like silver, red, and chartreuse. I think you'll be all right with those. I think you'll like that. But that's the one good thing about, you know, tying your own jigs. You can test them. Try to find something nobody else has got. You know, something you can't buy in a store. And just the basic satisfaction of going out and catching some fish with your own jigs. The fall bite's getting close. Turning on. Getting a little better every day. This weekend it should be pretty good. You know, and you got another month or two where you got another good solid month of crappie fishing. Gonna get a little cold after that, and I tend not to go out quite so much when it gets really cold. I prefer to be right here in my garage drinking coffee and tying somebody else up jigs and seeing pictures of what they've caught on them. Ain't a big fan of freezing my butt off anymore. I like to talk about it. I can remember a lot of days being in a boat freezing my butt off. And I will this winter, there's no doubt. I'll still go out, torture my little boy, freeze him to death. Zach's a trooper though, he hangs in with me for the most part. I'm gonna take this one out of the vise and resituate it just a little bit, get that tail straightened out. Kind of makes it a little bit easier to see what you're doing sometimes. And I'll tell you what, instead of putting the red in this one, let's put a shot of blue in it. I've moved all my flash. I used to keep all my stuff up on top of the table. But all this flash, usually when you buy it, it comes with a zip tie on it. So I drilled a bunch of little holes in the bottom of my table. And I just slide little zip ties in there. And that way I can just kind of pull off a few strands. Keeps it a little more organized. But when I say a little more organized, if you see my mess, you looks far from organized. But I know where everything is. Most of the time. I'm kind of curious how good that blue will flash it up. But it's a good hobby to get into. Making them and selling them. Yeah, I don't believe you're ever going to get rich off of it. Actually, it's more of a satisfaction of somebody sending you a picture of a big crappie they caught or a crappie their kids caught off one of your jigs. You know, and you get that guy that responds back to you after he gets them in the mail and goes on about how nice they look, and that makes it worth it by itself right there. And like I said before, I ain't got nothing else to do at 2:15 in the morning. Like I say, if you're gonna, you know, learn how to do this, there's a lot of people on YouTube, a lot of people on Facebook. I got to give credit to. Tell you somebody I like watching is Bobby A. On, he does some Facebook videos with some jigs he ties. And if by any chance he's watching this, that little spinning wheel thing you got with all the jigs on it—that's pretty cool. I don't know where in the world you come up with that idea or where you come up with that little spinny wheel, but kind of neat. Gets my attention every time I see it turning. But that's another one down. It's a little bit of blue in the tail this time instead of red. Trim a little bit extra off of them. I usually send my tails. If I'm selling them to somebody, I usually send the tails just a little bit longer. And then they can trim them off how they want. We watch the colors in that. It's pretty cool. I like it. I definitely use them. That's all I got, YouTube. I think I'm going to bed. Going to call it a night. If you haven't yet, hit like, share, subscribe. Hit that bell. Let you know when I tie another jig or send me a message. Let me know if you got any questions, comments, something you want to see me do. That's all I got. Talk to you guys later.